So yeah, welcome everyone. This is the final part, part 4 that is, of the 25k scoop review. We're down to 3 players at this point. Got a bunch of legends still in. That is the wrong button. This is the right button. We got Romeo Pro sitting at 4 million, Wang over there, 2.7 million. And probably obviously with all the chips, so expect to see a bunch of pressure here, three-handed. These guys will probably try to get that ladder. Let's get into the action, see what happens. My head is bald, by the way, because we were drunk and shaved it. Just so you guys know again before there's a bunch of questions. Froby is going to put in the pressure. Expect one to like rejam here, technically. Not sure if he actually does it. We obviously see a bunch of surprising plays for him, but against the white, Froby's opening range, I think it jams just the best. Line. See if Froby just goes for a small bet to fold and hands the king 10. And I expect him to just fold in. Maybe he comes in with the float, 10 of clubs, and back to straight draws, but obviously out of position as well, so we'll see. Just a fold. Romeo Pro just gonna limp this one. There's lots of tanking before the decision's gonna, like, before they make the decision, so I just try to skip through it a little bit. Queen 6-3. Blind versus blind spots are interesting. I think Romeo should check him off in the betting. I think a 3 should bet a decent amount of the time. And check in is pretty close here if you want to continue or not. Seems like the fold is the best play. King 5, easy open jam and fold. 9's with the duels. King 10 gonna defend. Outflop him. We see a small C bet. And just a call, raising is also fine to flop against the sizing like that with king 10. Totally reasonable at the stack depth. Probably still want to chop. I don't think he's keen on chopping. Jack's back on the turn now. I don't think he achieved much by betting the turn again. I'm on the check, you're somewhat in a weird spot. I expect to see mostly fold if you see a lead here now from Romeo. Expect a pretty big sizing. I mean, with king 10, you're always good here. So you want to just extract max value. And yeah, I think with 9s you just got to fold at this point. A bunch of like the queen check, check 10 flop floats get there. Obviously ace 5, 5, 6 got there. There's no need to bluff a 4 or anything like that. So yeah, not surprised. We see a limp and a jam, putting the max pressure with the wrong being short. And then you have to fold king jack again. I kind of like the rejam, man. That's max pressure. Holy shit. Like, doesn't even give him the chance. Got from in for limp jam or limp call, just piles it in. Romeo got a fold. It's a long. What the fuck? Tanks forever, then opens, alright. Because obviously Romeo can't do anything while Wang is that short. So it makes sense to apply the pressure. Quickly going through the break. Check deuce with the open, 4-3 just folds. He's got to wait for 1-2 bust right now, so he gives him a walk with the 9-7 as well. King 3, easy open jam. X5, easy open jam. Gets a walk with the 9 deuce. Interesting spot now for the ace with suited. Very interesting spot. For Probius as well, if he wants to rejam here or not, or a flat, or a 3-bet. I guess we might see a 3-bet. No, he just lets it go. New hairstyle. Yeah, let's just put it new hair, not necessarily a style. Romeo has an easy call. Surprised to do so, and then he heads up. Yes, they are. Wang finishes in third place. Backing a nice little 442k, and now we have a 130k heads up match. Probably obviously with an insane chip advantage at this point. And we see a limp with the queen for suited. Check, check on the flop. Romeo has the best hand here most of the time, so expect to see a lead. And just takes it down with it. Alright, I probably can't skip too much here, so I'm just gonna wait. Heads up, it's a bit tougher to do so. Just hope there's not too much like balance tanking preflop or something that makes it tougher to watch. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see a bet here on the flop. But he goes for the check back. I mean, heads up is always complicated, depends what strategy you follow. There's people that play it very differently, I would say. And like their styles. Obviously the double check, that seems very crazy with the 10-8 to me, for example. I feel like that's a clearly a clear two street value hand. You know, you definitely want to bet it twice. So I would have expected him to bet the turn and the river then. But he goes for the check, after the double check back. Seems pretty crazy to me, and probably gonna re-raise now. Like king 10 leads the turn, probably like check 9 leads the turn very often. So the 10 doesn't really do too much, and therefore like a raise here, and obviously for 3 deuce we just see a snap fold. But yeah, it seems very reasonable. Expect to see like them raise now a bit more. When you're short stacked and heads up, you usually limp a bunch, and then when you get a bit deeper, you start with open raises. Check 3 is probably pretty close here to an open or fold. But he comes in with a limp still. Flops top pair. I mean, so far we've seen like quite a few checks from him, but expect him to go for value here now. But maybe he checks it back. We'll see. There's the bet. And just takes it down. 6 is raised up. King 5 defense. Please stand on both sides here. Yeah, like a bet. Romeo should like mostly call here. I think occasionally raise it, but very, very often just call. Imagine you play like a fine table for this long and then you still have like the time to just go into the tank for every hand, try to kind of stay balanced in that way. Seems like pretty exhausting. Definitely expecting the sixes to check back the turn, right? At that point, you're just value owning yourself with a double barrel. And Romeo, like, probably checks here most of the time. Maybe can throw in a little block bet, like a quarter. Get value from 5-6, some 3x that he bets in the flop. Yeah, that's the quarter bet, and probably should just snap call here. There's obviously not that many hands you beat here, and there's not that many bluffs, but there's enough to always make it a call. Seems like a fine line on both sides. Does he go for the limp again? No, this time he raises. I'm pretty sure, yep. Clear defend with queen 8. I mean, he's already checked back with 10-8. Let's see if he wants to bet his ace 9 here. I mean, it's obviously a different board texture with the king high, but he does go for somewhat conservative check back again. But obviously totally fine, like I'm just saying, not very conservative, I guess, but he plays with a lot of flop checks in his heads up, which we don't really see. Makes it tougher to play against, in my opinion. Obviously, when your opponent has a high c-betting frequency, we can just check range, check raise a lot, and know that his range is fairly wide, but now he has good hands and like different parts and weak hands at different parts of his range. So it makes it a bit more complicated to play against. Probius has a pretty nice hand here. Queen of hearts make it a bit better. So he goes for the over bet. Look at his fucking sizing, man. I love it. Obviously representing the 8 with an 888,000. And 880 chips sizing. And Romeo has a pretty nice calling hand here. Yeah, I don't hate it at all. I mean, ace 9 off is such a clean call there. Because what is most likely bluffs? Probably hand like check deuce off with the check of hearts. Queen is off with the queen of hearts, you know. Something like that. And with the ace 9, you just don't block anything. So, yeah, I like the call. If you think your opponent finds enough bluffs. Which I think we can generally expect from these high-level players. He raised the check off over the limp. I think I would personally check it most of the time. I'm not sure, like, I'm not that great in blind versus blind play. I mean, I think I'm decent at blind versus blind play, but heads up is different because your opponent's on the button and you're not in position anymore, right? So, that 8 bet, I love it. It's tough for me to give my opinion on everything. I think check 3 of clubs gotta be a float here if you decide to call a preflop, which I'm also not sure about. But yeah, he should definitely float here on the flop. But he raises it. I mean, that is very fine as well. Just continue in some way. I don't like the... I love the re-raiser. The This is what I want to say. I don't mind the re-raise. I like it, actually. There's definitely some 6x that you want to re-raise here. Some 4x. Some flush and straight draws. Or this hand. This just depends how wide he expects room here to raise over his limp. That is very sexy. Just takes it down. A7 piles it over the limp for 20, 23 blinds. Seems pretty reasonable. You're out of position, you just want to take it down. And it's not that A7 off plays great there, post-flop. Small c-bet. Romeo should just fold here every time, I think. What up, Rumper? See? Goes into the mandatory tank at this point and then eventually lays it down. 8 for suited, limp, and a check. Ooh, very interesting. Just comes in with the lead now. I have no idea what that is. Literally no idea. He cannot comment on that. But I do believe Romeo should just call here. This is just me not knowing enough about heads up, so I just take it in and yeah. I don't really understand why you would want to be leading the spot texture. Should just go check check. And then this might be a river that probably is bluffs. You can expect Romeo to bluff a bunch of his 10x on the turn, maybe. I mean, he doesn't have that many 10x. Yeah, I guess he says a bunch of 10x. Like ace 10, king 10, checks back the turn, 10 8, maybe 10 9. That's weird, man. That flop, you already, like, you have no idea what you're playing against, right? Like, at some point, suddenly leads half pot in this turn, flop. What does he have? It's really tough. And now he bets the reverse well, and he's sitting with the 8-4. You saw the straight last time. He went for a bigger bet, though. Very, very tough spot for 8-4. It's just such an awkward spot with that flop lead. Let's see if he finds the call. That is an incredibly tough spot. It's so disgusting to see that lead on the flop. I mean, you literally have no idea what you're playing against, I think. Pretty dirty. 10-7 with the defend. No, a small bet and just a fold. He's down to 100 million. Pretty smooth heads up so far for Probius. Got the value when he wanted. Got the bluff through when he wanted to as well. Ooh, queen head offsuit here. It must be very close. I feel like queen 9 be definitely calling. Queen head offsuit seems very close and he folds it. Even though he was dominating your opponent, but... yeah. Seems like Romeo Pro, like, from my perspective, is, like, a bit more, like, of a structured player, you know, lots of flop checks, just really thinks through, goes for a bit more open limping instead of open jamming or raising a shorter stack depth. I feel like he seems like the better player to me from my little perspective here, what I've seen. Yeah, like, raises like this, I think, I mean, I'm fine. It's for me. I expected to see a rejam here. Oh, he did. Yeah, oh, yeah, there's the. Oh, okay, sorry. don't wanna ruin you guys this bet. But yeah, expect to see a rejam and a call. See if he can dig his way out of this one. Lots of chop outs, and there it is. Heads up continues. This could be another all in. Very likely to be. Limp. And definitely expect him to jam here. And then we see a call. Hoo-hoo-hoo, that's a sexy flop. And that's the get there. Got a straight and a flush. And heads up continues. Never easy, huh? We see more limps and a check. And then just a bet and a fold. Check 9 raises it up in the small blind. I'm trying to skip through it to make it like interesting. Just hope it's not too fast. And another small c-bet here. And he has a bunch of decent backdoors. But this is obviously the danger, I would say, in playing heads-up poker. You will find yourself on the flop so often with hands that have like decent or somewhat decent backdoor equity, maybe a bit of like some overcards. So I think often people end up c-betting too wide. We see a double barrel here. That seems very crazy to me. Romeo should just be calling here, I think. But goes for a rejam to protect his hand. Makes some sense as well. But yeah. Just defends the ace 80 versus the raise. Yeah, makes sense. I mean, at this point, he won a couple of pots, so he's deeper. I think with like 25 big blinds, you just look to get it in preflop. But now with like 40-ish or something, just gonna defend. Easy call on the flop. And I think this is not a hand you bluff with on the river. Probis has an easy value bet, and then you just need to decide if you want here or not. I feel so far Probis hasn't seemed, or like struck me as a guy who goes bet, check, bet too much as a bluff. I mean, we only had like two spots, I think. I can only recall one spot right now where he did it, where he had the opportunity to do it. So I don't know if he would bluff a lot here. And Romeo just lets it go as well. That's a nice fold. Not a limp pot. Once again, we have one of these hands that have like has like decent backdoor equity. Obviously, Probis has a bunch of 2x and 3x when he checks back. And we see another check by Romeo. So he plays with a very high flop check frequency versus Probis that does c-bet very wide on the flops. Pretty interesting so far. I mean, Probis' strategy is, I think, easier to execute because you just don't find yourself in weird spots like this. I mean, Romeo checks back the flop and now he faces this lead and just has to let it go. Blinds go up. Romeo has 31 bigs. Very short now. See queen nine with the open. And just a fold. Gets the walk with the queen seven suited as well. And this is probably just getting in. We haven't seen like a 3-bet bluff preflop yet or something like that. Like a non-nutted hand 3-betting pre yet. I think with nines you definitely want to induce. And there's a 3-bet. See if Probis finds the 4-bet jam. I mean, feels pretty weak to just fold ace it off here, to be honest. So yeah, he piles it, snap call for the nines, and whew. Yep, that's a lockup on the turn. And we almost have ourselves an even heads-up match. Seems reasonable. And then fold with a 9-4 offsuit. Unfolds a 10-5. Expect Romeo, like Romeo limps a lot, man. He's like, oh, he's such an annoying opponent to play heads up, it seems. But switches it up now with the 2.5x. I mean, as I said, like many times now, he checked a lot of flops so far. See if he fires here. Once again, you have a backdoor straight draw, the backdoor flush draw, an overcard. And there's the bet. It's a very small bet. Expected to see bigger sizing. King 8 isn't going anywhere. Just depends if he wants to call or raise here. I think there's good arguments for both sides. I tend towards raising a bit more given that smaller sizing, but obviously calling seems very reasonable as well. And there's the fold. Now it comes in with the limp of the King Deuce. Strikes me as very random, to be honest, given that he has been raising a bunch before and he just comes in with the limp fold. 5-2 suited, he uses to apply some pressure against that limp. Sure, and just folds check those. Now limp says 9 as well. Okay, so Probis comes over and starts limping lots of hands on the button. I'm really surprised by that, to be honest, just because we've seen him raise a lot when short stacked, and now we see him limping more when deeper stacked, versus technically you want to do the exact opposite. When you're short stacked, you want to limp, more. So yeah. Seems interesting. Love the top guys playing high stick since high stick goals have a limp. Yeah. I mean, it makes sense to have a limping in a raising range. I'm just surprised. See, probably it's like switch over from like a purely or almost purely raising strategy to a limping strategy as well now. So this is a limp pot. Quite a wait. Yeah, this is a limp pot. I'm just surprised he didn't raise it off with the limp. Check, check on the flop. Check, check on the turn. I would definitely value bet a 5 here. I mean, a strong 5. If you had like 5 deuce, you could think about checking, but king 5 is like a clear, clear value bet here. And yeah, Romeo takes it down. So I expect. Oh, okay. Probably says check more now. Interesting. Don't really understand this lead. I guess you expect to have the best hand most of the time with a6 there, so. Seems alright. Yeah. Oh shit. Oh shit. Is this where Romeo Pro turns it around? That's a pretty good turn for Probius. That might save him quite a few chips. Mostly expecting a double barrel here from Romeo, obviously. That is not that big of a sizing. This feels like a sizing where people want to check back river quite often. Bit under half, a bit over half pot. Yeah, I should just go bet snap call on the river. And then they're pretty damn even. See what sizing goes for. Maybe another like 60% bet here. Nope, goes close to pot. That's a snap call. And yeah, he just got very unlucky there. Nothing you can do. And now he raises them for offsuit. Yeah, like I don't really understand Proby's strategy. I think he just goes for it, you know, goes with the flow. Here to enjoy the show. And very right limps here from Romeo. Like, this is a clear cut raise with the check 9 suited versus the limp. That's just a fold. So, yeah, it seems like Probius goes over to a raising strategy again. Romeo might think about 3 betting this hand. It is. And obviously, a clear call from Probius. I don't think you want to like 4 bet get this one in ever, so. Folding is obviously out of question as well, so it's just like an easy call. That's what he does. You see a flop. Interesting board. I think this should favor Probius that has more flushes in general, and especially this middling board texture should favor him a lot, so I expect Romeo to check his hand all the time here. Now, Probius can think about bluffing the flop. It's very reasonable, in my opinion. He has a lot of like flushes. He has a lot of top pairs. Two pairs, straights, you know. So I wouldn't be surprised to see a bet here, or no, a check. Both hands make sense. Or both styles make sense. So he fires 40% and obviously just gets the fold. We see another 3-bet now with 9-6 suited. King Queen just calls. Ooh, this could be an interesting one here. That could be a very interesting one. Once again, this middling board texture is pretty decent for the guy that called you 3-bet. But obviously, you have a bunch of hands that are also good here, like any over pair, pocket 7s, ace 10, king 10. Let's see if Romeo comes in. I mean, he should just call here, I think. It's kind of weird when you raise and have to fold. Wow, this could be a sick one. This could be a sick one. I mean, probably just comes in with a double heat barrel here, I think, every time. And then Romeo obviously has an easy call on the turn, and then might occasionally hero the river with king high. It's a pretty small turn sizing. Clear call for Romeo, and the river is a sixth. Pretty bad river for him, I fear. Like, it seems like a lot of 8-9s are getting there. It's a pretty interesting spot, honestly. I could see Probius checking this and giving like Romeo Pro to turn a hand like this into a bluff. He's also gonna have, like, Romeo also is gonna have a bunch of 2 pairs and straight that he's gonna value jam. But I guess he's gonna call them anyhow if you jam here. So he's probably just piling it in. Yeah. Now it's a tough spot for Romeo. I think, nah, not a tough spot. Like, it seems like a very clear fold. Hands like 8-9 get there, hands like 8-5 get there, hands like 5-3 get there. You kind of hope your opponent has a hand like queen check with a spade that bluffs here now. So yeah, easy, easy muck. That's a pretty sick runner. That's so perfect for Probius there. And so he has a big chip lead again. Sorry. Yeah, just checks it. And then goes check, check on the flop. Right. Very small turn sizing. I think so too. I think you should definitely go bigger on that ace turn than like that 40% sizing. Not surprised. And the ace is... I mean, I guess he is not even that great of a card for him compared to the other guy, but still, like, favors you. Romeo comes in with, like, that kind of mergey turn bet. Easy call with 5-9. No, I think Romeo should just take a showdown value here most of the time. He's, like, he's still good a decent amount of the time. He might just bluff his hand as well, but I think you should just try to get the showdown. We see a open and a call. Wait. Okay, yeah, we do see an open and a call. I just want to make sure there's not like a limp call or anything like that. Yeah, c-bet and takedown, very standard. Kings with 8 deuce. Not much happening there. So 5 gives the chance to the 3-9 to see a flop. So this is like one of these spots, as I said, like, I think Romeo is just going to check here. And occasionally bet his hand, but we've seen him check hands like this plenty of time. Alright, this time he just goes for it and gets the fold. And this is also the nice part, you know, now he just folded out 6 outs from your opponent. And he has a chance to hit it twice, so he has like 25% equity there. So it's very nice, just fold it out. 7-10, easy defend. Wow, they were quick with that flop check. So flop and check check. I just skip by 10 seconds, right, so... Clearly went check check on the flop of the raise pre-flop. It's a sick turn for Probius. Might be a turn where Romeo wants to lead. And he does exactly that. Now I do expect to just see a call here. I mean, raising just seems a bit pointless with all of the draws out there. I mean, you just fold out draws when you raise here, you know. And if he has a check, he probably goes for two streets anyhow. But he does come in with a raise, and it's just an easy fold for Romeo. Oh, we see a super punt. But I doubt that. Romeo doesn't strike me as a guy that would do that. He finds the fold. Very well done. Check 3 limps. A6 checks. Let's check check on the flop now. A6 has an easy check call on the turn here if Romeo decides to bluff, or maybe he waits till the river to do so, and he does. Yeah, just check, and now Romeo should probably bluff this. And he's not gonna have that many weaker hands. And there's a snap call with bottom pair. You can only do these calls against opponents that are checking down there with obviously garbage as well, like we've seen there. Against most people that we usually play, that's just not going to be a good call. Surprising regen with the check 9 suited, a hand that flops very well. I feel like that's not usually a hand that you want to have in your 3-bet jam range at the stack depth. You just want to see a flop with and try to win some bigger pots. What's the better of these two guys? So far, I thought Romeo was a bit better, but it's obviously from my humble opinion. Check, check on the flop. But I mean, Probius got him good as well, so he got the value when he wanted with a big bet, then he got the bluff when he wanted as well, so those two worked out for him. Goes for the blockish value bet. Let's see if Romeo finds the fold with the king high. And with the 7-8, you think you have the best one here most of the time. Lots of 9x are betting the flop. And it's in a time pressure and decides to call king high. Obviously not unreasonable, but I feel like that's not a spot where Probius has that many bluffs. We haven't seen that many like crazy bluff on these. Let's say, yeah, board textures where you don't have that many bluffs, you know. Just by default, which is one of those boards, you know. He has so many like 7-3 offsuit, 7-2 offsuit, so He just has to turn some random hands into bluff, which I'm sure we just haven't seen him do it too much yet. Seabed. It's very tough to continue with ace-3, so... He just comes in with the float. Pretty sick. What a turn. clearly betting, and obviously can't continue anymore there. Limp in a check. Check, check, flop. Check, check, turn. Probably check, check, river. Yep. Now we just see, like, Romeo Frulus every hand. Very reasonable play, though. Like, there's nothing he can do, I think. Like, nothing was absurd or something. That's just clearly bad. Bunch of tough spots, obviously. Seabed. I think he should be doing something here with queen 5. Maybe float. Maybe raise. Folding here seems just too tight. Yes, raise. Probably has a like clear continue here. I might be in as a rejam, but I feel mostly as a call. And that's just such a horrible turn. Like the 3 on the turn just makes it tougher to represent a bunch of hands. And if your opponent has trips, he's never folding, and not too unlikely he has trips here. I kind of like a small bet from Probis here, just to fold on hands like this. Maybe a bit delays it to the river, but he obviously has plenty of value hands that he can represent, so I like it. Yep, that's a small bet. Now queen 5 just goes into the muck. I mean, yeah, Probis plays this really well, but this... It's just such an awful turn again for Romeo Probis. He's also getting a bit unlucky in the heads-up matchup here. After he even had a really sick start, by the way. I mean, he was up to pretty much even stacks. 3-4 limps it. It's kind of a spot with the 7-8. You don't really want to raise call it, so you probably end up just checking here. Because raise folding seems also pretty awful. Yeah, I mean, regem is obviously profitable, so that's fine. But I just hand like just hands like check 9 suited, 7-8 suited. I just want to play bigger pots with them, you know? I don't want to just pick up some free chips. Like one big blind, you know? Should obviously be a pretty good board for Romeo. We expect Probis to raise maybe all of his ace-x preflop against the limp, 20 big blinds deep. So I lean towards just betting the floppy again to protect my hand, but you see obviously Romeo just plays with a lot of flop checks, so mixing like a lot of small bets as well. A lot of weaker hands to protect the checking range. This 7 seems like a nice hand to bluff the river with here. Like, you're so low in your range, you can credibly represent a 9 or a 6. And easy call, obviously, with a 5. Oh, wrong button, I apologize. We see a limp and a check, and a button to fold. Yeah, I don't like that, guys. Just an open fold, I guess. Yep. Preflop action. Once again, limp check, probably. This has been the story of this heads-up match. Oh no, this time we see a raise. Let's quickly look at the sizing. Whew, very big sizing. I mean, we see Romeo limp like a lot of hands that you should technically not be limping here. And this could be it. I mean, this is definitely just a hand you want to rejam. I mean, since it's actually kind of close between a 3-bet call and a 3-bet jam, I think. The thing is, even if you pilot, he's probably like still calling 4, so... Should just be fine. Obviously, he's 8 never folding. Oh. Romeo definitely got the better end of the all-in sets up so far. So with the 2.5x now, I mean, obviously an easy 3-bet, and then we just see a fold. Check 10 open. 5-9 is pretty close here as a defender. I lean towards just folding it. Maybe he decides to 3-bet it, or something like that. Yeah. I mean, 3-bet is definitely better than defending. Check 10 is just a clear call here. Let's see a flop. Once again, I lean towards just c-betting here, given that you have more, like, more of the better ace-x. But I mean, checking. I mean, 5-9 seems very decent as a check as well. Interesting spot with check 10. He blocks some 9x combinations that he might 3-bet. Some backdoor equity. Doesn't seem like the worst hand to bluff with here, but generally it's just a weird spot. But yeah, we see a small bet on the flop. I like it. I feel like this is a spot that I underbluff a lot, but given the stakes that I'm playing, when opponents 3-bet you preflop and then check the spot, they usually just have kings. Who picks up the open end on the turn? Seems tempting to double barrel. The thing is that you don't have that many like strong value hands that you want to double barrel here. Like ace queen gets it in preflop, sixes get it in preflop very often, if not always. So you have like ace six suited. And then we like already getting shadow, obviously hands like ace eight, ace check, maybe ace 10. But just not that many hands. So you're representing a hand that wants to bet flop by turn and mostly check back river, in my opinion. And plenty of bluffs in this situation. Decides to call it on the turn. I feel like it's close. But as I said, I feel like Probis doesn't have that many value hands. It seems like a pretty reasonable call if you're expecting to have enough bluffs. Probis hits that chin river. I mean, that's just perfect. And it's just a very awful river for Romeo Pro. Once again, just a bunch of the bluffs get there, like check 10, like 10-7. 8-7 might occasionally check back now because he knows he's good against hand like king 6, or maybe 6-5. Romeo doesn't have a time bank here, so it's tough to see if he finds the call. It's a very crazy spot. But yeah, I like the fold. It's pretty sick. Sick play by him. I mean, the call on the flop pretty good, the return call very good, and then the river fold also very solid. So keeps his cool there, and then finds the river fold. Then check 10, deuce 9 with the check, and yeah, this time we see the flop bet. Like, I just like these flop bets. Your opponent doesn't have that many ace-x, let's just go for a value here with the check 10, you know? Gets a walk with the king 4 as well. See if he decides to limp the sevens as well, raise it. If he's like a hand you want to be raising with. But, yeah. Raise it to 6, takes it down. These are very out of line raises. I don't think to do 6 off raise is going to be profitable long term. Obviously, this time he just faced a hand where your opponent couldn't do anything. Easy limp with the A10. We've seen some large raises here before. Which I like against Romeo. Like, he has been limping very, very wide on the button so far. I should definitely not fold the A10 here. Let's see some cards. I would be very surprised to see a fold here. You're in position. It's not a bad price. Ooh, this could get interesting. Both flop a gut shot. And we see the flop bet, a third. Call here most of the time. I think occasionally raising would be fine as well, but this SPR is kind of weird. You also don't really want to raise and a fold to a jam. Interesting, now you pick up flush draw as well. Same for Probius though. Sorry. It comes in with a double barrel for small sizing. I like the small sizing on the turn here, just given how short Romeo Pro is. And I think against the sizing, you should be calling again with the 10-8 and the flush draw. Just gets a prick again. I mean, obviously not the best river for Probis here, but I still think he should be pining just because he doesn't block 8-9, 10-9, 10-8, any of these hands. Doesn't block check 10. Doesn't block any, like, ace-8 or whatever, so I think he has a clear jam with his hand. And he gets the fold. Obviously a tough one to make in-game, but I'm still very good. Alright, now we just see a jam and a call, I guess. Yep, that's a snap, obviously, with a6. Mostly a chop, occasionally a one-hand Vincent. This time looks pretty good for ace-5, and that's the final hand. Probably still very good in that heads-up match, but it wasn't like Romeo Pro got wrecked there. He ended up cashing. Let's have a quick look at the last second again. I mean, I guess it's just on the screen as well. Let me quickly go over to the screen. 576,000 for that win. Pretty sick. A lovely triple barrel there with the 5-3. And the end is obviously just a standard cooler and then a little suck out. I hope you enjoyed this 25k review. That was actually fun. A lot of spots where I was really not sure what's going on. I think we saw like a lot of interesting flop checks, ICM pressure and stuff. Was cool. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know if you want to see more like this in the comments. And maybe find something else that's coming up. Otherwise, I'll see you with the next video on this channel. Don't forget to subscribe. Take care.